Today we have with us on our panel our special guest, a youth icon of the state Himachal Pradesh, Shri Prashant Chopra. Prashant Chopra is a cricketer and belongs to Solan in Himachal Pradesh. We welcome you on behalf of the Swaraj Report and CV Channel team, Prashant.
Thank you.
Prashant has a lot to share with us today. Prashant, since you belong to a family of cricketers, your father, Shri Shiv Kumar ji, is a cricket coach and is also in Sports Authority of India. So you had a training and grooming at home. You had one guru, one mentor as your father in your home. But did this inspiration come from within, or were you being asked to join cricket since your father was a cricketer? How did it all start?
It all started in Solan. He used to go to train all the students over there. He was the coach in Thodo Ground in Solan. So I used to go with him when I was a small kid, and he gave me a bat, a broken bat, and his trainees actually cut that bat from a wood maker and gave it to me like a half bat. So after they completed all their training, then they used to make me play some balls. So it wasn't a forced one, it was my love for the game. I just loved playing cricket, I enjoyed playing cricket, and it was never forced on me that you have to pursue cricket only. In fact, he was like, you have to be good in studies and you should study. I used to complete the training from the ground in Solan, then I used to go for my tuitions as well. So he never said that, okay, you have to just only be on the cricket. He just said, okay, cricket is one, now you have to go for the tuitions as well, for your studies as well. So it wasn't forced on me. It was my own decision that I just loved playing games. So I enjoyed playing, and till now I'm enjoying only. So I just love playing this game.
So the passion for cricket comes to you from within.
Yeah.
You were yourself passionate to come into cricket. And it isn't the family legacy only that came down.
No. It's my love.
What do you have to say about HPCA? Himachal Pradesh Cricket Association is now a world name because the youth icon and the most eligible the youth personality of this nation, Shri Anurag Thakur, has also been made the BCCI chief, and he's the youngest ever BCCI chief. So what do you have to say about HPCA?
First of all, I would just thank all the HPCA members, HPCA, and especially Anurag sir. He's supported me all through my career till now, and he's been a great help, and because of him HPCA has evolved. I remember I just played for the first time in Himachal in 2006, under 15. I played in Nadaun in Hamirpur. The ground at that time wasn't that good, but now people go and see that stadium. It is a world class, like it can be an international stadium as well, because it is as good as an international stadium. It is located, we have almost like three stadiums located at such beautiful locations, like Dharamshala is. You see the facilities in Dharamshala, those are world class facilities. People used to say that Dharamshala, oh, the venue, the view from there is like you are in South Africa. But no one says actually that there is a lot of facilities also available over there. There is a hell lot of facilities available over there. You have all the facilities for the players. There is an indoor stadium, you have high tech gym, and all the trainers are over there. Throughout the year, HPCA is taking care of all the players. We can go at any point of time of the year to go and train over there. All the players, not only the Ranji Trophy players, the players who are playing the junior level cricket also, they can go there, train over there. If we have some injuries, that can be sorted out. They have their own physios as well. So they have maintained it, and they're doing a fabulous job, because actually you need these facilities for the players. When you have these facilities for the players evolve. Then, as it can be seen that from the past few years, HPCA has evolved, and the players are making big in all the formats, and they're known in India as well, around the world also. Like HPCA is a team. Earlier, it wasn't seen like that. From the time Anurag sir has came, all the stadiums like, it's not that only one stadium we have, an international stadium. Okay, the job is done. No, it's not like that. He's like, I want to make as much stadium that I can make in Himachal to promote cricket in Himachal. In small villages also is made, like in Nadaun, it's an Amtar stadium, it's inside a village, and it's, if you see that stadium, it is a very good stadium. In Bilaspur you have a very good stadium, and they're taking care of all those stadiums, and promoting all the cricket in all small towns as well. So that's a big bonus for all the players. So all over, HPC and Anurag sir especially are doing a great job, and that has actually helped me as well. So I need to thank all of them who's been not known, unsung heroes, like not known, like the people who are behind in HPC, all the support staff, all the ground staff, all the people who are just giving their thoughts, like how they can improve the conditions of the ground, the curators, the ground staff, the management staff, all the one. I need to thank them, and I wish them like they can do the facilities more better, and they are doing it, and it's helping all of us. So it's been a great help from Anurag sir and from HPC.
Do you think the BCCI president, Mr. Anurag Thakur, has done a commendable job in promotion of cricket in the state? And is there a transparent, democratic system for selection? Is the selection system in HPCA transparent? Are the capable cricketers getting a chance to play? Do you think Anurag Thakur, who has been recently appointed as the BCCI president, deserves the stature? And has he turned on the expectations of all the deserving candidates, the deserving cricketers? Has he done a good job?
Yeah, he has. Actually, he's done a very good job. No player from any at any level, from under 15 UC to Ranji Trophy level, there isn't any one player who will be like, no, he's not performed. All the players have to go through the same selection process, the same tournament they have to play. It's not like, okay, that guy has played Ranji Trophy for 4 years, so he doesn't need to play the district tournament for his side. He has to play, he has to perform. If he performs, he'll be in the camp. And in the camp also, he has to be passing all the barriers that are the fitness levels. He has to match those fitness levels. All the levels he has to be. If he is fit enough, okay, done. One thing is done. Then the your performance comes. So you have to perform at every level. It's not like, oh, you have performed in the districts, now the game is over, you are going to play for Ranji Trophy side. It's not like that. You performed well in the district, now you have to go for the selection, and the camps as also you have to perform. So all the it's a clean selection process in HPC. It's never been like that, okay, some high profile guy is just kept in the team. Okay, not like that. It's all the players are based on their performance only, and that can be seen by the performance of the team on the Ranji Trophy side. Like, we played Ranji Trophy semi-finals last year, one day semi-finals we have played. We are playing Ranji Trophy, the day's tournament also, we are playing at a good level. Just one or two games here and there, it happens, but the ratio of performance has gone up to a great height. Like, all the people know that, okay, no, there are players from Himachal as well, and Himachal is a team. So we beated Saurashtra, who were the finalists of the Ranji Trophy team, Ranji Trophy season 2015-16. We beated Saurashtra in league phases. So that gives this clear sign that the team is based on the performance, and all the capable guys, all the deserving guys are getting the opportunity. So he's done a great job. Anurag sir is always like, no, I want the people who are deserving in the team. I don't want He never wants a player who's like, okay, some high-profile name. He just wants the team. He wants HPCA to be like, all the people get that chance. All the people who are deserving get that chance. So all the guys are actually getting those chances.
And a lot of expenditures has been incurred in maintenance and setting up of these three stadiums: the Dharamshala HPCA Stadium, the Nadaun Stadium, and the Bilaspur Stadium. You as a cricketer, do you feel that all the stadiums are being well maintained, they are being well looked after? Do they have appropriate facilities? Do they have the required infrastructure? Do they have all that maintenance staff, that all the money spent is being taken well care of? Are they well maintained?
Yeah, they are very well maintained. Dharamshala, obviously, it is well maintained because it's an international stadium. It will obviously be well maintained. But other two stadiums, if you look at those stadiums, they're as good as Dharamshala. Only there is no floodlights over there. In coming years, I hope it will be there. Only that thing is not there. But all the things, you have gym, you have AC, like dressing rooms you have, good dressing rooms you have. You have rooms for the players over there. So it's a beautiful set up over there, and the approved period groundsman, I've been seeing that ground person in Nadaun from 2006 when I played for under 15. He's still the groundsman over there, and he's always everyone is, whenever we go at the stadium, we are, it's never been like, okay, oh, they're not taking care of this ground, it's been like the grass has gone away or something like that. It's always, whenever we go over there, it's lush green outfield, lush green stadium, and we love going over to Bilaspur and Nadaun. Obviously in Dharamshala, it's a Ranji Trophy international stadium, so it will be taken care of. But the other two stadiums also are very well maintained and very well taken care of by the local ground staff and the people engaged over there with the association. So it's actually very well taken care of.
In a recent interview with Shri Anurag Thakur, we spoke to him. He shared with us his vision and his future plans to organize state level matches, state level tournaments on the format of IPL. Do you feel that that could be a success?
Yeah, actually it will be a success. We've been hearing he's planning to organize a league in Himachal as well, so that the players, local players who are not getting opportunities at the IPL or some those leagues, so they get an opportunity over here, they can make a name of themselves. And obviously HPC needs talent, so they have a lot of talent, so why not express that talent in front of the people? Everyone has that league also. So if Anurag sir is planning, he is actually planning, it's a very great idea, it's a very good idea actually. And I'm very hopeful and I'm sure about that it will be a great success in the state, and everyone is eagerly, all the players are waiting for that if this league happens, everyone wants that league to happen, and it will be a great success.
C for cricket, C for controversy. Cricket over the years has been circling around a lot of controversies. A lot of bad name to cricket has also been brought through match fixing and the internal politics in the cricket organizations. Do you feel it affects the talented cricketers at large? It discourages them when they see these kind of things happening in cricket? Or is the organization working on some reconstitution for a more transparent system for cricket?
Yeah, they are actually, BCCI is actually organizing anti-doping and anti-corruption classes for all the states. We have our classes over there, the representatives from the BCCI are coming over here teaching us about all these things which are happening. So how can we be like safe from all these things? Because it's not only the senior levels, the junior levels, the coaching, they are starting from the junior level as well, so that the people, the players are actually known about these things, so they know what actually to do when an unknown person or with a wrong intention comes to you. So you know actually what to do. So they are actually doing the best they can, and they are actually teaching players, giving their knowledge to the players, what exactly they should be doing. So, and I don't think it could discourage a player. It's like these things never player see and say like, oh shit, he wants to perform, he wants to play, it's his passion for the game, it's love for the game. If that person loves that game, he'll always be boosted up, no, I want to play for the country, I want to serve the country, I just want to make country proud. Obviously he wants to make his name as well, but he wants to make the country proud. Everyone has that dream. So actually we are well taught, so it's not an issue. The BCCI is working on that, and in further years also they'll be bringing up more steps, that we know which is the hotline number we have to be dialing during the matches and all these things. There are representatives from the BCCI who are coming to see that no mobile phones and all those things are used during the Ranji Trophy games as well. So this is a good learning process for the players at the junior level as well.
You yourself are a youth icon, one of the most eligible youth icons in the state in terms of cricket. Recently, Mr. Anurag Thakur has been appointed as the youngest ever BCCI president in the history. How does the youth of the state, the players at large, the cricketers, and you speculate Anurag Ji's performance? Is this appointment of Anurag Thakur as the BCCI president would be a success? Would it be more better for the cricketers, more better for the youth of the nation, since a youth can better understand a youth, do you think he would be one of the best presidents?
Yeah, obviously he will be one of the best presidents. First of all, I need to congratulate him. He's been the youngest president, appointed as the youngest president. So I congratulate you, sir, for being appointed as the youngest president for BCCI. And yeah, he will be successful. He has a great vision. In the past, he has done a great job for HPCA, made HPCA known all over the world and all over the country as well. So obviously he will do. Earlier one have done their job. It wasn't like they haven't done their job. They have also done their bit. But I hope that Anurag sir will obviously take BCCI to a new level, new height. And I wish him all the luck that he will do justice, and he will do justice to his work. He is that kind of a person. He has that love for the game. It's sheer love. He has done what he has done for HPCA. It's out of love for the game. It's nothing like, okay, he's done of his personal interest. It's been his love for the game. And his love will be continued in BCCI president as well. So he'll be bringing up new steps, new things which will be helpful for the cricketers. And it's obviously a great booster for the cricketers from the state as well. Like people know that, okay, HPCA is a state and there's a player, there's a person who's been appointed as the president of the BCCI who was the president of HPCA. So this is a great milestone as well, and a great booster for the players as well.
Have you had any bad experiences, any such phases in cricket in Himachal Pradesh which you still remember?
Yeah, I actually remember a very bad experience. It was during our Ranji Trophy season 2014-15. Our first game against Goa, it was actually. So the morning we woke up for the match, we were well prepared. We all had a vision that we want to play the Ranji Trophy finals this year. We want to win the trophy, and the first call we get from the ground that the grounds are closed. The government has sealed the ground and there will be no match from today in HPCA Stadium, Dharamshala. That was a very bad experience. Then they did, Anurag sir and everyone did their best so that that match can happen. That match happened after 1 o'clock. And that match happened, we won that match. So that was a very bad experience during that time. Like all the time there, you are not going with that in that stadium with, like, this is our stadium. You're not able to go like that. There are securities over there, there are police officers over there. Obviously, they are doing their job. They have been told by someone.
So you feel politics sometimes touches sport also? It damages the...
Won't be answering that directly, but yeah, sometimes it happens, but we can't say what's going on in the between the political parties. We can't say what's going on, but being a player, we want that the game should never be affected. We just want that.
You as a youngster, as a young cricketer, feel that politics should be kept out of the sport?
Yeah, obviously.
There should be no politicization of cricket?
No. Cricket is one, it's a game. It's a game. Be it a game, not be a political issue over things. It's been a lot of games who have been spoiled. Like hockey has been the national game of India. Where is it right now? It's been like political parties came in, hockey has been banished. So political parties should be stayed away from the cricket or any game.
It's politics should be kept aside from cricket.
Yeah, any game, not only cricket, any game, it should be kept aside. Like, it's a game, people are playing, guys are playing, they are showing their talent. Why have the political parties to interfere? So it's their talent, they are giving their talent over there, they are doing the best they could do for the country. That's the best thing. So let them do. Other issues, I don't know, I don't want to go into that also. So it's, yeah, that one experience was very bad.
And in the end, we would request you to give a message to the young cricketers, the growing cricketers, the upcoming cricketers, since you have yourself achieved a very strong startup in the cricket era. What message do you want to give to the youth of the state, of the nation, and to the cricketers of your age who are growing?
My message for all the youth of this country is that if you are playing any game, any sport, not only cricket, any sport in this world, just play it with your heart. Play it with your heart. Give everything to that sport. Even if you are not getting, things will come to you at some point of time. It will definitely come to you. People, some guys are like, oh shit, I've given 3 years to this game hasn't given me anything till now. That is the testing period. Just give yourself, remember one thing, that why you started playing this game. You started playing this game because you loved this game, not out like, okay, I want to pursue it as a career. Career is pursued with education, okay, that you're pursuing your career, you know what you have to do. But you play a sport because you enjoy playing. You remember the days when you were a small kid, you just went out on the field to play a soccer or cricket or lawn tennis or hockey, anything. You just love playing all the sports because that's a recreation for you. So enjoy the sport, enjoy it, play it in the true spirit. Don't indulge yourself into bad things. Just give your 100%, and even if you are pursuing education, do it with full intensity and full love, that okay, I want to play and I want to make my life out of this education only, and love the education as well. Okay, you have given your 100%, 110% to education as well, not only sports, but even if you are pursuing education, just give your 100%, give your 110% to that thing. Never leave any one column unfinished. Finish all the columns, okay, this thing is done, I need to give my 100%. Just love everything, enjoy everything, and live life, live every day as if it's your last day. What best you can do in your last day to make your last day memorable. So if it's your last day today, you need to make this day very memorable and very enjoyable, so that you are happy when you go off to the bed. It's like, okay, I've done everything, I have no columns are left, I've enjoyed my day, I've done everything which I could do in this day, and enjoy it, and I'm sleeping off now happily. So that's my message, and all the best to all the youths and all the people of this country, not only the youth, the elder ones as well. So all the best to you. That's it. Thanks.
Thank you, Prashant. We thank you for your valuable time. It was Prashant Chopra from Solan in Himachal Pradesh, who feels the Himachal Pradesh Cricket Association is doing a commendable job. He applauds Mr. Anurag Thakur for his democratic, transparent selection system. He appreciates Mr. Thakur's vision and congratulates Mr. Anurag Thakur on being appointed as the BCCI youngest ever chief. Thank you. We request you to promote young talent, to cheer for Prashant whenever he represents our state and nation. Thank you. Signing off from the Search Report News. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat Mata, Jai Punjab, Jai Himachal.